Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to shapes of molecules involving covalent bonding. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question 4, the structure of compound A is shown. This is compound A. Some of the carbon atoms in compound A have a tetrahedral arrangement of bonds. Some of the carbon atoms in compound A have a trigonal planar arrangement of bonds. How many carbon atoms are there of each type? In tetrahedral arrangement, what happens that one carbon makes four single covalent bonds with four other carbon atoms and the bond angle is 109.5. While in trigonal planar, what happens that we take double bond as a single bond, so therefore in total there are three bonds and the bond angle will be equal to 120 degrees. Let's find out which carbon is making four single covalent bonds. So we have CH3. The carbon is bonded with three hydrogen atoms and one carbon. Second is also CH3. This is also making four bonds. This carbon is making four single bonds, two CH3 and two with the ring. Again, we have two hydrogen atoms on this carbon. So this is also making four bonds. Similarly for this. This carbon is making double bond. This is making double covalent bond. These two are also making double covalent bond. This is making double covalent, but this is making four single covalent bonds. Similarly, we have this CH3 and this carbon is also making four covalent bonds. Two with hydrogen atoms, one with OH and one with this carbon. So in total, we have nine carbons which are making single covalent bonds and the arrangement will be tetrahedral. So option C and option D could be correct. Now let's find the carbon atoms making three bonds. We have one hydrogen with this carbon. So this carbon is making one double covalent bond and two single bonds. So the arrangement will be trigonal planar. Similarly for this carbon, again we have one double covalent and two single bonds. This carbon is making one single bond with hydrogen, a double bond with carbon and a single bond with this carbon. So this is also trigonal planar. Similarly, this is also trigonal planar. This one. And these. So in total we have eight carbon atoms that are making at least one double bond and two single covalent bonds. The answer is therefore D. Question number 4, the eight species that follow all have covalent bonds. In which pair do the species have different shapes from each other? A is beryllium, chloride and carbon dioxide. You know that beryllium belongs to group 2 of the periodic table, so it just has 2 electrons in the outermost shell and it makes covalent bond with chlorine atom which has 7 electrons in the outermost shell. So this structure would be linear. And the bond angle is 180 degrees. Looking at carbon dioxide, we have 4 electrons in the outermost shell of carbon. And it makes a double covalent bond with one oxygen and a double covalent bond with the second oxygen. Again, when finding out the shapes, double bond is considered as a single bond. So again, this is a linear structure. And the bond angle is 180 degrees. So in A, both have linear shape. So this is incorrect. B is CH4 and NH4+. Again in CH4, carbon makes 4 covalent bonds. And the bond angle is 109.5. The structure is tetrahedral. In NH4+, what happens that nitrogen makes 3 covalent bonds with hydrogen and one coordinate covalent bond with H+. Again, there are four atoms attached with the central nitrogen, so the structure is tetrahedral. Both have the same structure, so therefore this is incorrect. C is NH3 and BF3. In NH3, we know that nitrogen makes three single covalent bonds, and a lone pair is also present. Lone pair occupies quite a space, and the name of structure is trigonal pyramidal. While in BF3, there are just three electrons in the outermost shell of boron, so it makes three covalent bonds. There is no lone pair present in boron atom, so therefore the structure is trigonal planar. So in C, both have different shapes, so therefore C could be the possible answer. In D, we have sulfur dichloride and water. Now both sulfur and oxygen are from group 6 of the periodic table, so both have 6 electrons in their outermost shell. Sulfur makes 2 covalent bonds with chlorine, and 2 lone pairs are also present. The structure of water is also similar, because oxygen also have 2 lone pairs of electrons and 2 single covalent bonds are being formed with hydrogen. So both structures are bent structures. So therefore D is incorrect. The only correct option is C. Question 1. Which feature is present in both ethene and polyethene? Ethene is C2H4. We have double bond between two carbon atoms. The structure will be like this. In polyethene, polymer is formed from these ethene monomers. So what happens that double covalent bond is converted into single covalent bond, and long chain of carbon atoms is formed. A, bond angles of 109 degrees. As we can see that in ethene, 3 atoms are present around the central carbon atom. So now bond angle will be 120 degrees. While in polyethene, around central carbon atoms, 4 bonds are present, or 4 elements are attached with single covalent bonds, so the bond angle will be 109.5 degrees. So option A is incorrect. B, pi covalent bonds are present in both ethene and polyethene. As we can see that in ethene, pi bond is present along with sigma bond. The first bond is always sigma bond, and the second covalent bond that is formed is always pi bond. While in polyethene, we can see that all bonds are sigma bonds. There is no pi bond that is present. So B is also incorrect. C, sigma covalent bonds. Now we can see that sigma covalent bonds are present in ethene, and sigma covalent bonds are also present in polyethene. So therefore C is correct option. D, sp3 orbitals. Now hybridization of orbitals can be found by looking at the central atom. In the first one we have ethene, so the central atom is carbon. Now carbon is directly bonded to 3 other atoms. So we can write 3 plus number of lone pairs on carbon, which is 0, it equals 3. If the number equals 3, then it will be sp2 hybridization. If the number equals 4, then it will be sp3 hybridization. If this number equals 2, then it is sp hybridization. And also the shape of orbital is sp3 or sp2. Similarly, in polyethene, we can see that the central carbon atom is bonded to 4 elements directly. So it is 4 plus number of lone pairs, which is 0. Now 4 means that the hybridization is sp3. So we can see that in polyethene, sp3 orbitals are present, while in ethene, sp2 orbitals are present. Therefore D is incorrect. Correct answer is therefore
C.
Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.